Hello, and welcome to the session in which we would look at a CPA exam question that deals with how many units will a company needs to sell to earn a 10% return. I like this question because initially it looks intimidating, but it's going to illustrate the concept that I always try to tell you about. The CPA exam tests your basic knowledge. What does that mean? It means if you know your basic accounting formulas, and I mean by basic introductory accounting formulas, you should be able to answer most questions on the exam. And that's the purpose I want to go over this question. Two, I'm going to show you two methods on how you solve this problem. One is the GMAT method, and one is the accounting, the CPA method. So I just want to make sure you understand that you have more one way on tackling a problem like this. And this concept is really tested in a managerial accounting, basic accounting course. Even if you're not an accounting major, you should be able to solve this problem as long as you did well in your managerial accounting course. So whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I am a useful addition to your CPA course. The difference between what I do and your CPA review course is the following. The CPA review course is simply a review course. It reviews the material with you. I teach you the material. So if you don't know the material, you will find hard time taking advantage of your review course. So this is how I can help. I can help you clarify it, give you more examples, give you the journal entries, give you the theory behind it. So when Peter Alinto or Roger or Wiley gives you the shortcut, well, it makes sense to you. Your risk with me is 1 month of subscription. Your potential gain is passing the exam. And if not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university doing on the CPA exam. This is a list of all my course catalog. That includes many other accounting courses, advanced accounting, governmental accounting, taxation. My governmental accounting is pretty popular. Also, my CPA supplemental resources are aligned with your Becker, Roger, Wiley, Gleam, so it's very easy to jump back and forth between my material and your review course. Also, I have all the AI CPA previously released questions, approximately 1,500 of them with detailed solutions, so you can take advantage of those. Connect with me on LinkedIn if you haven't done so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Like this recording. Share it with others. Connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So let's take a look at this question to see how we would solve this question. Adam is planning to manufacture a dinosaur toy based on the Jurassic World Camp Cretaceous show. The expecting selling price is $30. We have variable manufacturing cost, variable selling, fixed manufacturing, advertising, and product design. And let me write the numbers because I know some of my viewers are blind. Variable manufacturing cost is $20, variable selling is $4, fixed manufacturing is $50,000, advertising cost is $50,000, product design is $50,000. And Adam wants to earn 10% return on this operation. They expect this dinosaur to sell for a year, and after a year they will cease this product. So how many units will Adam need to sell to earn 10%? Now, do you know what 10% is? How do we compute the 10%? Well, the 10% is rate of return. It means you have to earn, your profit has to be 10% relative to sales. So when you take your profit divided by sales, it should give us 10%. So as I said at the beginning, I'm going to show you how to solve this problem in two different ways. And it relies on your basic knowledge of a basic formula you would learn in managerial accounting, which is the variable income statement. What is the variable income statement? Well, we're going to have to take sales minus variable cost will give us contribution margin. Then if you deduct your fixed cost, you're going to get your profit. Simply put, you're going to take the profit divided by sales, and the answer that's going to give you 10%, that is your answer. Now, what you can do is the GMAT way is to kind of, okay, if you know that your formula, try it out. Take a look at some numbers and see how it works. Well, let's do it the GMAT way. Well, your selling price, let me just come in, also kind of condense this formula a little bit further, kind of as a review for you, because this is what I'm trying to do. Selling price minus variable cost per unit equal to the contribution margin. So the selling price is $30. You have variable cost of $24. Minus 24 equal to $6. So simply put, your contribution margin is $6 per unit. And what you do now, you say, if my contribution margin is $6 per unit, pick a number, pick 60, pick 80. I'm going to pick 60. I'm going to pick $60. So if I'm making $6 per unit, and I'm going to just randomly pick 60,000, and I'm going to multiply it by 60,000. That's my contribution. It's going to give me my contribution margin. I can also do sales, you know, take 60,000 times $30. I can take 60,000 unit times $30, 60,000 unit times $24, then subtract them, or I just computed the contribution margin per unit. I just want to make sure to show you the different ways. So if you take $6 contribution margin times 60,000, and that's going to give us 360,000, 360,000. Now our fixed cost, fixed manufacturing cost, advertising is a fixed cost, product and design development is a fixed cost. Fixed cost is 180. 360 minus 180 will give us profit of 180. Now what we have to do is look at our profit and look at our total sales. If we're selling 60,000 unit, $30 a piece, that's going to give us $1.8 million in sales. Well, guess what? I happen to choose that number and it happens to be 10%. So if I take 180,000 divided by 1.8 million, that's going to give me exactly 10%, and that's my answer. So $60,000 is my answer. And how did I solve this? I solved this by just picking it, knowing my variable income statement and picking a number. So that's one way to do it. I'm not saying this is the way to do it. That's one way to do it. I'm going to show you how to do it relying on your knowledge of the variable income statement, which is, this is the variable income statement, which is you have to know by heart when you sit for the exam, because the variable income statement, remember, it's going to help you in the CVP analysis. Any CVP analysis, if you have a good foundation of the variable income statement, you can work with that. Okay, let's work basically the accounting way or the algebra way. Let's not call it the accounting way, the algebra way. So the profit, we don't know what the profit is. We know that sales, profit relative to sales, we know sales is $30 per unit. So sales is 30Q, $30 times the quantity. Profit divided by 30Q, it should give us 10% or 0.1. 0.1 or 1%. Now we can solve for profit. If we solve for profit, so profit, cross multiply, profit equal to 3Q. All what we did is we cross multiply. So now we have profit equal to 3Q. Again, back to the formula, back to the variable income statement formula. And if you're not comfortable with the variable income statement formula, this is what I do in my managerial accounting. This is what I do in my cost accounting course. This is what I do in my CPA review course. I cover this formula in details. On the CPA review course, they may spend 3 to 5 minutes on this formula. I spent maybe 3 hours in terms of exercises and lectures. So by the time you're done with this, you'll be fully know this inside out, including the CVP analysis. So basically what it boils down to is something like this. Again, we know the contribution margin. So let's do this. I'm going to walk you through the formula step by step. So we know 30Q minus 24Q equal to 6Q. So we know our contribution margin should be 6Q, 6 times quantity. Minus the fixed cost. We know the fixed cost is 180,000 altogether, and the profit should be 3Q. Now it's easy. Now we can solve the formula. 6Q minus 6 times the $6 contribution margin times the quantity sold, which is we don't know we're solving for, minus the fixed cost equal to 3Q. 3Q is 10%, which is sale. I'm sorry. 3Q is the profit, which should be our profit right here. The profit should be 3Q. Now we solve 4Q. 6Q, we're going to subtract 3Q on both sides. So it's going to be 3Q equal to 180. We're going to be 3Q. We're going to subtract 3Q from both sides and add 180 on both sides. 3Q equal to 180. Now Q equal to 180 divided by 3. Q equal to 60,000. We're back to the same answer, 60,000. So I showed you how to solve this in two different ways. Obviously, on the CPA exam, it should not take you this long. Real quick, you need to know this by heart. You need to know this formula by heart. Again, you can use the GMAT if you're really good at that. Say, okay, let me plug this number in the formula and see if it gives me, profit will give me 10%. Or you can solve it well using this algebra formula, and you'll be able to do it. So it should not take you long. Although at the beginning, The question looks a little bit intimidating, but again, it boils down to, do you know your basics? And this is what I keep emphasizing on for the CPA exam. You need to, if you have strong basics, you should be fine. But if you don't have strong basics, even if you know the advanced topics a little bit more in details, it's not going to help you, because the exam tests your basic knowledge. Test it in a challenging way, though. Although it's challenging, so if you know the basics, you can do it. If you know the basics, you can get lost very quickly. At the end of this recording, once again, I'm going to invite you to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. Again, I don't replace your CPA review course. That's not what I do. I am an adjunct. I'm a helper. I assist you in understanding the material better. The CPA exam is a lifetime investment. Don't shortchange yourself. You pass the exam once. Throw everything on it. $30, it's not going to break you. You try it for a month. You like it, you keep it. If it feels it's helping you, you keep it. If you don't feel it's helping you, if you feel it's really rather than helping you, it's hurting you, contact me. I would refund your money if that's the case. Study hard. Good luck. The CPA is worth it. And most importantly, stay safe.